A majority of the research that I do is focused on coatings for aerospace applications. So we're talking about composite surfaces or metallic surfaces that a coating would go on top of to improve the performance of the vehicle. It's all sort of been focused on what's happening right there at a surface of interest. These coatings are really important for NASA because for these next generation aircraft, airflow is going to be really important. Our coatings don't do anything to the airflow itself, but what they do is allow the airframe designers and engineers to build their aircraft to utilize this laminar flow, and then our coating is going to help that aircraft maintain that flight through the course of its daily travel. The primary things that we've looked into as we've developed these technologies is ice adhesion mitigation and insect residue adhesion mitigation. So these coatings work by looking at what would happen if a contaminant comes into contact as a series of steps. So if we're talking about ice adhesion, when a supercooled water droplet comes into contact, there's going to be an initial expansion of those residues. And so what the coating does is it has chemistries and topographies implemented into it to prevent that initial expansion from occurring. Once that initial expansion step is over, it further prevents adhesion of those residues that have come into contact. So by using what's called surface modifying agents, we're able to controllably change surface chemical composition without changing the bulk mechanical properties. Also, by looking at surface topographical change, we're able to control what happens at the moment of a potential contaminant coming into contact, which is really beneficial for some of these extreme environments, such as aircraft wing. Wind turbines are another important industry that I think could benefit from this. There's also opportunity in the marine coatings industry, as well as the automotive industry. There's other places, such as in architectural coatings, as well as power lines. And there's opportunity, I think, for each of these industries to find utility with these technologies. I think if you're a commercial entity and you're considering these coatings, really see what it is that these technologies can provide as far as maintaining a coating surface and keeping the performance of whatever your application is for longer periods of time.
This NASA technology and many others are ready to be transferred to your business. Find out more by visiting technology.nasa.gov.